Hey YouTube, it's Kelly, and welcome back to another episode of Dying the Dead. Today we are going to be doing the trypsin digestion. Here are some of the things that you're going to need. Your specimens, an empty jar or container, your scale. You're also going to need your tweezers, little papers to weigh out your materials on, lab gloves, your goggles, your 100 milliliter graduated cylinder, distilled water, borax, and last but not least, the most important chemical of this step, trypsin. We're going to be transferring our specimens into the trypsin solution anywhere from 1 to several days. Or until the body becomes fairly limp and the skeleton is visible. Larger specimens, however, need to stay in the trypsin bath for more than a week sometimes. One thing to note is you're going to want to change the solution if this process takes more than 3 days or if the solution becomes blue. Some of you may be asking, what's trypsin? Well, trypsin is a proteolytic enzyme that digests muscle. The trypsin digestion that we're doing today is going to degrade and soften the tissues, and it's going to remove the alcyon blue from any non-cartilage tissues in our specimen. We're going to start off by first making a 30 milliliter saturated solution of sodium borate or borax. To make this saturated solution, we're going to be adding sodium borate, or our borax, to our 30 milliliters of distilled water until it no longer dissolves into the solution. And so what that means is as you keep mixing your solution, you're going to see the particles build up towards the bottom. And once that happens, you know you have a saturated solution. To that, we're just going to be adding 70 milliliters of distilled water and then adding in 1 gram of trypsin. All right, so let's get started. For this step, you're going to need a small pan. Measure out and add 200 milliliters of distilled water and then turn the heat on high. You won't need this much to make your trypsin solution, it's just easier to measure out 30 milliliters from a larger volume. Now wait for the water to get to a rolling boil. Once there, turn the heat off and remove the pan from the burner. I will be transferring my boiling water into a different container. Next, add in some sodium borate or your borax and stir to dissolve it into the water. You may need to add more to make sure you're making a fully saturated solution. Once you've mixed in as much sodium borate as you can, let the solution cool to room temperature.
20 minutes later.
Now that our solution is at room temperature, we will measure out 30 milliliters. The sodium borate crystals that have formed at the bottom can be discarded as we do not need them. Now that we have our trypsin digestion solution complete, we're going to be transferring our specimens from our distilled water from the rehydration step into the trypsin bath. So here are our specimens in our trypsin digestion solution. We're going to be leaving our specimens in the trypsin digestion solution for 1 to several days. It really just depends on our specimens because we're going to be looking for a limp specimen, and we're also going to be looking for the muscles to become transparent so we can view the skeletons inside them. So my mice have been soaking in the trypsin digestion solution for about 3 days now. After being in the trypsin solution for about 1 day, the solution that my mice were in turned blue, which meant that I had to change the solution and put them into a fresh one. So let's go take a look at some of the clips from day one. Specimens, they are limp, but I can't really see their skeletal systems yet. So because the specimen's spine and bones and stuff weren't too visible yet, I left them in the solution for another couple days. You don't really want to leave your specimens in the trypsin digestion solution too long, as the trypsin can actually digest the bones of your specimen. So I kept it at 3 days max just because I didn't want to go any further, and I didn't really want my bones of my specimens to be digested. So now we're going to take a look at what our specimens look like today. So this is what my mice look like after being in the trypsin digestion for about 3 days. You can see that they have become very limp. When I picked them up, you can see that they're kind of just very floppy when I'm moving them around. But looking over them and looking at their legs and stuff and their arms and their spines and things, you couldn't really see the skeletal system. The specimens still look very blue. They don't really look too transparent. I personally don't really see too much of a change in like what they look like in terms of their color, in terms of how their muscles and bones look. The mice don't look as transparent as I thought they would look. I thought they were going to look more like a whitish blue, a very see-through translucent blue. But they still kind of look, you know, brownish, and you can't really see through the muscles and stuff like that. So, okay guys, so don't forget to read the description down below and comment any questions or anything that you guys would like to tell me into the comments, and I will read all of them and I will get back to you guys as soon as I can. Don't forget to thumb up and subscribe to my channel for more videos if you like what you're seeing and you just want to know about this process or you're just interested in what I'm doing. So join me next time when we're going to be starting and preparing the alizarin red stain or the bone stain for our specimens. See you guys later. Bye!